Hey guys, I feel it's your first day here on the Oreo Faction, and this week's theme is baking. So, got little Kayleigh in it. Just like you can make them walk of fame. Right, Kayleigh's here, and we're gonna make double chocolate Oreo cookies.
That's triple.
No, because we don't want dark chocolate.
Oh, no, we don't. No.
No, we don't.
That's not the question.
Wouldn't recommend these if you're on a diet. If you're not, eat them.
Same.
Yeah, okay.
Ow,
well, let's go. Like we are using dish
zesty lemon because
washing up liquid, you know, for like, our hands. So you need to wash your hands, guys.
Yeah, and you just put lemon.
Lemon grab.
Enjoy your hands. Then you get an adult to preheat the oven because you shouldn't be doing that for a kid.
Yeah, because we're too
safe.
Safety
first.
Yeah.
The thing is, Kayleigh isn't using salt, but I don't know what she's doing. Whiz together your butter and sugar until it's a smooth consistency.
Right, basically,
get that butter and sugar.
Well,
we need scales.
Yeah, that's what I was going to just say.
Right, we need 200 grams of
butter. So, yeah. It looks like it's got wings. Like a superhero or something weird thing.
Right, we got 199 grams. You need 200, but I'm not that precise. So. Then you get 300 grams of caster sugar in the same bowl.
I'm gonna mess up this.
Me. That's 303, but no, it's alright. Yeah, just scoop it back up. Now it's 304, that didn't go well. Okay, well, that's about right.
No, you know, like, nerdy nummy, she's like, wait, so what
let's mix
now?
That all together.
Did you, like, mix it?
Yeah.
Will, it's a dog.
Matilda, I don't know where you wet leave. You mix the butter and the sugar until it's a smooth consistency.
This is what we've done so far.
Can you try to mix it? It didn't do anything. So we're gonna get the electric whisk. I think we have one.
Maybe. You could have just got it in the first place, maybe.
Yeah, I know, and then you're like, no, you should just do it.
Oh, you're back.
You use this. Right, so we've been like mixing it and like whisking it. We just like we've done like a mixture of both for like in just 10 minutes, and like, it's just like, basically it looks a bit like scrambled egg or like
gross stuff,
mashed potato if you do it really badly. That's what it looks like right now. So we're just gonna put the egg in because that's the next step, and this is like nearly smooth, but like,
can I put this tanned egg in?
Yeah, and we're just comparing our skin colors.
Literally, it doesn't even like, what is this, like, seriously,
this is me if I was an egg compared to like anyone else.
Me, I think that's actually my color too.
Yeah, that's darker than me.
Which one should we use?
When the egg is dark.
The tanned one or the special one?
The special one. Boy.
It just like.
Right, the next step is to add the dry ingredients and blend it together. And if your mixture looks too dry, you add some milk. So,
mate,
that means.
I've already put the egg in.
Yeah, Kayleigh already put the egg in. But it said crack the egg in and then put your dry ingredients. So now we need the self raising flour, 275 grams. And the cocoa powder is 75 grams. Okay, that's 400.
Wait, no, let me just get some away.
Okay, you're using an eggy spoon. That's 275 grams.
Actually, it's 298 now.
No, it's because of the spoon. It's 274.
Alright,
yeah, now, no, wait, you need cocoa powder as well.
Oh,
nearly forgot.
Forgot about that.
That's between 74 and 79,
so now we're just mixing it, and it looks like what Wreck-It Ralph lived on, that little heap of mud right now.
You're not even filming it. There we go.
And like,
yeah, if it's too dry you can like add some milk.
So we're gonna add milk, and we've already got the milk out, so putting a dash of milk in.
A little dash.
Me. It smells pretty good, to be honest.
Now it really looks like a little dark pile.
Okay.
It looks like a dark pile.
Actually does. Okay, so we added a bit more milk whisked it, and it looks like this, and it's not really like doing anything. What's it doing? Like, seriously,
I thought it was supposed to be like sticky because I've made these before, but
it's just like not doing much, isn't it? I'm putting a bit more milk in, and it's gone a bit more stickier, but it's just like looks a bit more like the dirt pie again.
Right, the mixture looks like this. It still kind of looks like a little dirt pile, but I think it's a bit more organized dirt pile.
Yeah, and it looks like the same color as them, so that's
don't eat you, there's salmon out.
We all did in it, but you know, Kayleigh, we just did it anyway.
It's a conspiracy theory about salmon out, but we're not gonna go into that because what if it's not and we offend someone. Right, now we're going to do the chocolate. We're going to do the Oreos actually. Right, we're going to get these Oreos. I'll put them into two because two sandwich bags, and then
I'm crushing
them up.
Can you just like use a little like rolling pin to crush them?
We're going for a bowl because you can't find any sandwich bags. Should I use this? This is for like meat and steak, isn't it? I'll just use this because it looks
vegetarian.
Oh, me. It's a lot better with a sandwich bag. That's what it looks like right now.
I like seeing it crunched on.
I'm just going to keep going until it's in like little pieces. They look like this. I'm just going to leave it like that because when they're inside the cookie, it'd be better if there's like big
things. Mine looks better.
Yeah, Kayleigh's is a bit better because she had less Oreos in hers and she just did it better.
Can I just put it in now?
Yeah. Ah! I'm sorry, why did I do that? Kayleigh's just going to mix them in. And I'm gonna.
Oh, this is really hard to make in.
And I'm gonna break up some of the chocolate. We have. It's all melted because it's been on top of the oven where it's preheating. Okay, we're gonna put in some of this. We've got white chocolate and milk chocolate.
Oh, can I do the white chocolate?
Sure. The white chocolate, milk chocolate. They're double chocolate cookies. We probably should have gone through what the ingredients were first, didn't we?
Oh wow.
I just thought that. Okay, so I'm gonna break these up and put them inside the bowl. We've got all of the chocolate in here, and now, delicious. Meat. Then you should get two. What are these called?
Bacon trays things. I'm not sure.
Two trays. It just says tray. Get two trays and line it with baking paper.
Grease. It's already got like cookies on it anyway.
I'll just use these crinkled volcano scissors.
Dang.
Was that crinkly edge?
You see what I was just doing with my hands?
No.
I'm just trying.
The baking paper doesn't really fit the tray, it just like sits on top, but
we'll just. It doesn't matter.
Deal with it, we just put the blobs on top and hope it'll go down. So then you get your mixture and you get like little blobs, I think. You use your hands to separate the mixture into 10 blobs.
You decorate.
Okay, so we've got them on the...
Yeah, I've finished now.
So now we're going to put them in the oven. You put them in the oven for 11 minutes.
My hands feel like they're literally on freezing. They're freezing.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Things going off, it's been 11 minutes. We tidied up a little bit, but not really. Also, they're supposed to look like...
I didn't realise that there was a thing.
Jesus.
They're supposed to look like they're not done yet because... God, they used to.
I'm actually going to cry. What are those?
They look a bit like brownies or something. No, these gloves, not the best gloves. They seem to have a hole that I didn't realise. Make sure you use the gloves that don't
go in. Right, so we're going to...
Right, now you've got to let them cool for a bit. It says preferably 30 minutes, but...
30 minutes?
Yeah, but they taste nicer when they're warmer, so we might have them a little bit sooner. We are putting the, taking them off of the trays, which are cool down, and onto some plates, and...
What have you done? He died! He hasn't died yet, but... Wait, let me just get that paper thing off.
Okay. Right, mine kind of... Well, they're kind of like some one big
brownie. Mine have failed. Look at that, they're literally dead.
Make sure they're separate from each other. Right, so we left the cookies to cool for a bit, and now we've got a cookie each. Kayleigh might have eaten some.
Shut up.
So now we're going to do a taste test with the cookies.
Well, they really taste nice. But...
Mm. We've got a bit of white chocolate and Oreo.
They are pretty good, to be honest.
Really pen. Oh my god, that's actually so nice.
I think they're rad.
Yeah, still like a little bit warm, which is like pen. Great, love it. So, thank you so much for watching this video, guys. If you enjoyed it, please give it a thumbs up down below. And subscribe to the Oreo faction. Also, check out my channel, phegotflare, phegotflare. Mm. If you want more Kayleigh, go to her Instagram.
Yeah.
I don't know what your Instagram's called.
It's like peach, but it's like P-E dot, like, underscore dot A-C-H. Cause like,
yeah, that's it. Go check it out. I'll see you next Thursday with another new video. And don't forget to remember to celebrate life. Bye!